welcome to the Blindfold Chess Podcast. Welcome back to another episode. Today, I will be providing you with the locations of different pieces that are on the board. It is your job to figure out the solution by pausing the podcast before moving on. Today, we will be looking at three different puzzles, each around a different endgame theme, ranging from easy and working our way to hard. Here is your first puzzle. White has a king on e5 and a pawn on c5. Black has a king on d8, and it is white to move. Again, that is white has a king on e5, a pawn on c5, and black has a king on d8 with white to move. Please pause and find the solution before moving on. The solution will come in 5 seconds.
One, king to d6. King to c8. Two, king to c6. King to d8. 3, king to b7. King d7. 4, pawn to c6 check. King to c6. 5, pawn to c7. King d5. 6, pawn to c8 promote to queen. Black resigns.
This puzzle looks at the concept of opposition. When the white king steps up to d6, it forces black to protect the queening square by stepping to c8. White follows up with the king to c6. If they could, black would pass, but black is forced to give up ground, and white will procure the queening square by stepping to either b7 or d7 to protect the square of c8. Time to move on to the next puzzle. This one is just a little bit tougher. White has a king on c4, a rook on f7, and a rook on h6. Black has a king on e8 and a queen on a5, with white to move. Again, that is a king on c4, a rook on f7, and a rook on h6. Black has a king on e8 and a queen on a5 with white to move. Please pause before moving on to the solution. The solution will come in 5 seconds.
One, rook to a7. Queen captures a7. 2, rook to h8 check. King d7. 3, rook to h7 check. King c6. 4, rook captures a7. Black resigns.
This one is quite incredible. Even with so few pieces on the board, white is able to sacrifice their rook since the black queen is trapped. The rook on a7 attacks the queen. The queen has no square to go to without being captured or allowing access to the ladder mate, by playing the other rook to h8 for checkmate. Black has to give up the queen and allow white to check the king and force it on the same rank as the queen. White will then win the rook versus king ending. I love that one. On to the last puzzle. This one is very tricky, and we'll be looking at a couple variations. White has a king on h8 and a pawn on c6. Black has a king on a6 and a pawn on h5. Again, white has a king on h8 and a pawn on c6. Black has a king on a6 and a pawn on h5. Please pause and find the solution before moving on. The solution will come in 5 seconds.
Variation 1. 1. King to g7. Pawn to h4. 2. King to f6. Pawn to h3. 3. King to e6. Pawn to h2. 4. Pawn to c7. Pawn to h1 promote to queen. 5. Pawn to c8 promote to queen. This position is equal.
This puzzle is Richard Reddy's famous endgame puzzle, originally published in 1921. Black has a passed pawn that, quote-unquote, can't be captured by the white king, while white's passed pawn is firmly under black's control. White needs to utilize the idea of multi-purpose moves in order to simultaneously move towards his pawn and track down black's pawn. We are going to look at a second variation now that contains sub-variations. So return to the starting position, and remember the position when we enter a sub-variation. Good luck!
Variation 2. 1. King to g7. King to b6. 2. King to f6. Subvariation 1. King captures c6. 3. King g5. Pawn to h4. 4. King captures h4. Position is drawn due to insufficient material. Subvariation 2. Pawn to h4. 3. King to e5. Pawn to h3. 4. King to d6. Pawn to h2. 5. Pawn to c7. Pawn to h1 promote to queen. 6. Pawn to c8 promote to queen. The position is equal.
I hope you fared well in the variations we had in the last puzzle. So that concludes our three puzzles for this week. Tune in next episode, where we will continue to work on our visualization and work on another game of the Masters.